Hi everyone, we're here at Devoxx 2014, and I'm here with Cyril Mottier, who's a Google developer expert in Android, and we're going to talk specifically today about Android Wear, because he is actually giving a talk about Android Wear at this conference. Welcome.
Welcome, thank you.
Android Wear is, Android from the very beginning has had different form factors and has from day one assumed that people would produce phones and eventually tablets of different forms and shapes, and developers had to deal with that.
Yeah.
Now we have Android Wear, so which obviously is a whole lot less real estate, but it's probably not just a smaller form factor. Tell us about how it changes things from a developer perspective.
Well, yes, as you said, Android Wear is not just a tiny Android. Actually, it's a tweaked Android that is made for wearables, and by tweaked, I mean that they completely reinvented the way that you interact with the device. And this is done mostly by creating a new UI, a new user interface, where the paradigms are completely different because you don't have a grid of apps anymore. You have a principle of cards, and each card is actually an information from one application that you can swipe or have more info about.
Right. So I think that that's really key to understand that, that people shouldn't be just trying to shrink down an application.
Exactly. So you have to think completely differently. And this is done basically by starting a completely new design process. So drop everything that you've done for the phones and tablets and try and start thinking about something completely new.
So
for a small form factor. And you also said about shapes and stuff like that. Actually, there is something which is quite funny because we've always been prepared as Android developers about different form factors, but they were always square or actually a rectangle screen. And now we have round screens, which is completely new to us, but the good thing is it's nice to see that Android adapts itself quite correctly to that kind of screens.
Great. So actually, I think what's important is to find a good use case for the wearable. We're
yes.
not about trying to take any and every application and take it running there. So the first obvious use case for which I understand you don't have much to do is notifications in general.
Yeah.
So a wearable is, or Android Wear is paired with a phone or a tablet. Yeah. So any notification you get on that device will also be mirrored to, and the developer doesn't need to do anything for that. Is
yeah,
that correct?
This is working out of the box. And the thing is, it's a spoiler about my conference that we'll do tomorrow, but basically there are three main principles on Android Wear, which is that your application needs to be glanceable, it needs to be contextual, and it needs to be or to require low interaction or no interaction. And when you think about those principles, actually, the only thing on Android, the current Android, I mean on phones and tablets that fits to these principles are notifications. So out of the box, Android Wear is displaying all of the notifications that are actually displayed on the phones and tablets. And those notifications are synced. So when you swipe away some notification on the wearable, they are also swiped from the phones and vice versa.
Yeah, so that's probably very good. In terms of using the notification API from Android, is there anything special you need to do so it looks good on the wearable as well?
Well, as I said, by default it works, but it's not quite fancy, so you can tweak the notification by using some wearable extender classes, which are provided as part of the support library. So by doing that, you can have access to some new notification features that are only available to wearables, such as you can change the background, you can have some principle of stacks or pages
right.
that are quite nice if you want to
group
you know, split
together
the information in several cards.
Yep.
Yeah.
So eventually you get to a point where this is not enough, you want to get to custom UIs, you want to build an app that actually runs on the Android system you have on your wrist.
Yes.
So that involves building a full new app, which eventually is an APK, which needs to make its way to the wearable. So take us through how hard it is, what it takes to actually, what kind of APIs you have available, what can you do?
Yes.
And maybe the workflow.
Yeah, so when you're stuck with notification, you have to go through the custom APK path. And what most people don't know about that is that actually Android Wear is just Android. at the time we're talking, it's KitKat. So what you're doing for tablets is radically the same as what you can do on wearables. So you have access to the exact same set of APIs, except some packages like USB. You don't have access to USB, WebKit.
It makes no sense
on a wearable. But when you're creating an application on Android Wear, from the technical point of view, it's exactly the same as what you can do on phones and tablets. What you really have to keep in mind that is that it's different from the UX and UI point of view. This is the only difference between Android Wear and Android.
Okay, I have another difference.
Yeah.
The wearable is not really connected, or it's connected to the phone, so
not
there's
now,
a data.
Not yet, but maybe it will in the future.
Okay.
And that's the good point of using Android in Android Wear, because actually Android is future-proof. So when, I don't know, when the technology will evolve and when wearable we have access to the network, then it will already be ready. We will have almost nothing to do because it's just Android.
Right, so roll back to today, to what we have and developers have today.
Yes.
They can mostly, they need to use the data layer APIs to exchange data and access the internet, for example.
Yeah.
Or so how does that work? The watch cannot make a call to the internet directly. It goes through the phone for anything it has to do.
Yeah, so nowadays what we have is a wearable that is connected to the phone, which is this, both phones and wearable are considered as nodes in a network.
Yes.
And because the phone has more capabilities than the wearable, it acts like a server to the wearable. So whenever you want to have access to some data on the internet, you have to make the wearable connect to the phone, so to send and ask for information to the phone, and then the phone will ask to the network, so for instance server on your backend. And all of that is done thanks to an API that is called data API, but actually there is two other APIs, but most of the time you're using data APIs because it's an API that syncs some data between the phone and the wearable automatically thanks to Google Play services. So this runs on top of Google Play services.
That's a very good point. I mean, Google Play services plays this really critical role of, it embeds most of the magic that happens.
It can be updated automatically without having to wait for a system update, which is quite nice because if there is some fixes to do, well, Google can push that automatically without asking carriers or.
So that was a quick abstract view of everything, but you've been doing some really concrete work on working on an application, actually shipping it and having people use it. Tell us about that experience. What is it and what does it do, and maybe some lessons learned?
Yeah, so I've been working on an application called Captain Train, which is a company that sells train tickets, but what we want to do is not just sell train tickets. What we want to do is to revolutionize the way that people experience train. And that means that we also want to improve the overall experience in the train. And one of the things that we have to do in France is to make the train agent, train controller, check a barcode, because this barcode contains actually your actual tickets.
Your e-ticket,
so, So because of that, well, we already had a phone application that was displaying the barcode. It was nice, but when Android Wear was released, I was like, we need to do that on the wearable because it's even more usable and easy to do. You don't have to get your phone out of your pocket or
unlock it.
And you just have to look at your wrist and present your wrist to the train agent, and that's it.
Yeah, so you get the notification, you know where you're sitting, and then when the controller shows up.
Yeah, there is actually two parts, the part prior to the trip and then the part during the trip. So yeah, you're right. There is also the part prior to the trip where you can have access to all of the information such as your carriage, your seat, and stuff like that, at what time the train is leaving. And then you have the barcode that you can present during the trip. So at the beginning, when I wanted to do that, I wanted to stay into the line and use notifications. But actually, we have one big problem with barcode like that, is that we need to keep the screen on because you don't want the wearable to turn off while you're presenting the barcode. And we also need to
And it needs to be for brightness.
Yeah,
too.
For brightness. Right. And because of that, we have to go through the custom APK path. And developing for Android Wear was quite nice, quite challenging, because As I said, it's very similar to what
it's,
we can do.
Well, it's new. It has rough edges. Yeah. It's got to have them.
Of course. Mm. Yeah. It's Android. It's new. It's not that new. But actually, what's new was the communication between the phone and the wearable. And I spent quite a lot of time,
understanding exactly what's going
on. Does, yes.
Maybe a little bit too bit of magic. Yeah. Magic going
and
on.
I think maybe the problem is I always try to deep dive into things and try to understand exactly how it works. Maybe it's okay for people that just want to do something and don't care about how it works. So basically, this application is automatically displaying the notification when it's important to the user. What we wanted to do is something.
It's contextual,
that,
really.
Yeah, it's contextual. We didn't want to have an application kit that you have to start when you're in the station, the railway station. So it's automatic. It's like it works like magic, and this is what Android Wear is. It just displaying just the right info at just the right time.
Right. It seems to fit very well with what wearable should be. And that has been out. People have been using it.
Yes.
Some good or bad feedback. Yes. Have people actually using it? That in itself is a good feedback.
Yeah.
I guess.
The thing is. There is not a lot of people having an Android Wear device on their wrist.
Still pretty
but,
new.
The people having an Android Wear device were like amazed because it's, well,
yeah, this is
quite,
it's this magical moment.
For now,
yeah.
But it's magical, yeah, because it just shows at the right moment and you can present that to the train agent. And I think the most amazed people were actually the train agents.
Yes,
because they were like, "What is that?" they were so proud to scan my wrist like that.
Yeah, and I'm pretty sure you had some fun too, doing that when it was not even released.
Yeah,
and they
especially
were the
during
ones.
The beta phase, because I was the only one having this application and the controller was. Well, I have never seen that, and
it's pretty easy for them too, right? They too don't have to wait for somebody to pull out, and so it's quicker and faster for them
exactly.
as well.
Exactly. So okay. It just works.
So I guess we had a quick tour here. Maybe I have one last final question. What kind of watch do you wear?
So I have the LG one.
Okay, tell me more about why you have this one more than another one.
Well, I actually have the Samsung one and also the Moto 360, but I decided to switch back to the LG one after using the Moto 360 for like three weeks, because I think the Moto 360 is nice. It's good looking, it's better than a square screen like that, but I think it's too big. And the second problem I have with that is that I'm a runner, and when I run with a leather bracelet, I sweat a lot, and I don't like to have the wet bracelet like
that.
Yeah,
of course.
And because this one is in plastic, I don't have that kind of problem.
Yeah, you can change straps.
Yeah, I can change, but actually I would like to change between when I'm at work and when I'm running. I would like to have two different bracelets, and this is not currently possible with Android Wear. I hope it will be in the future.
Well, we already have different form factors, different manufacturers, different everything, which is the idea of having, one Android Wear, but different implementations, different devices.
But
so
I've tested the application, for instance, on the three devices, and it was working correctly. So this is where Android excels. It works everywhere.
Great. So on that note, I think that's all the time we have for it. Thank you, Cyril, for taking the time. And go get some Wear apps. Develop them, use them, give us some feedback. Cheers.